U.S. State Secretary Antony Blinken meets with Chinese President Xi Jinping in Beijing. Their meeting is expected to cover trade concerns and China's support for Russia. Both Beijing and Washington express hopes for progress on several fronts, such as improving military communication and ease of travel. But they remain on a standstill on trade policies and territorial conflicts in the South China Sea. Prior to meeting the Chinese leader, Blinken met Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi in a 5.5-hour closed-door meeting. During their opening session, Wang told Blinken U.S.-China relationship has stabilized, but negative factors persist. In response, Blinken said active diplomacy is needed to advance their relationship. TikTok parent company ByteDance says there are no plans to sell the video sharing app. This is after the U.S. passed a law forcing China-based ByteDance to divest TikTok's U.S. assets in 270 days or face a ban. The company said reports that it was exploring the sale of TikTok are untrue. The U.S. government cited national security risks for the measure, as it claims it can be used by the Chinese government to spy on Americans. ByteDance has denied that allegation, and TikTok CEO has vowed to challenge the law in court.
Ayala Corporation is reviewing all its businesses in a bid to simplify its corporate structure. Meanwhile, Union Bank expects higher growth following the completion of its Citibank acquisition. Our correspondent Jackie Pascual is now on the line with those stories. Jackie?
Hi, good afternoon, Denise. Ayala Corporation, one of the country's largest conglomerates, is reviewing all its subsidiaries and units as it prioritizes where to put its resources. It wants to simplify its corporate structure and that of its companies. Speaking to reporters following the company's annual stockholders meeting, Ayala Corporation President and CEO Cesar Consing said they will focus more on businesses that are growing or those that can be scaled up. Some businesses, like its property and energy units, will get bigger capital expenditures this year, but others will have a lower capex. Ayala has earlier announced it was targeting to divest around 50 billion pesos worth of its non-core businesses, like its stake in Light Rail Manila Corp and Manila Water, and they hope to complete that by the end of the year. Ayala Land is also expected to merge all its 34 subsidiaries to simplify its corporate structure. This may be completed by 2026. Ayala is also streamlining its logistics business by integrating Entrego to Air 21. Ayala now looks to pour more resources in sectors they deem they can scale up further, like its health unit, its energy unit, as well as AC Mobility, which is now focusing on electric vehicles. Meanwhile, the Aboitiz-led Union Bank of the Philippines is also looking at higher growth this year following the completion of the acquisition of the Citibank consumer business in the country. This after the bank or Union Bank recorded lower net income in 2023. At the company's virtual annual stockholders meeting, Union Bank President Edwin Bautista announced that the integration and migration of Citibank customers to Union Bank has been completed in March this year, and this will have a positive impact on its financial record because now they no longer will have to have two parallel systems serving both Union Bank and Citibank customers. Union Bank plans to increase further its loan portfolio, credit card business, as it sets its sights to become the largest and most profitable bank in the retail segment of the banking industry. And that's the latest, Denise. Back to you.
Thanks for that, Jackie. The Philippine Medical Association welcomes the upcoming Senate probe on the alleged pyramiding scheme between doctors and a pharmaceutical firm. The group urges physicians and pharma companies to follow ethical standards to preserve the integrity of their profession. The Senate is set to investigate a scheme wherein a company is allegedly recruiting doctors to prescribe their products in exchange for luxurious rewards.
Bumulaga ito sa atin, ano? Bigla na lang because of the whistleblower. So, ang importante kasi sa ating lahat, no? We should be very vigilant as physicians, no? I think kailangan nating critically look at yung mga ganung alok, no? Kasi once inalukan ng ganyan, no? Nagkakaroon tayo ng tinatawag natin na conflict of interest. Ang pagdudoktor kasi ay isang bokasyon na bigay buhay at hindi hanap buhay, no? Mm-hmm. Kumbaga na tayo ay tinatrust, no? trust is the bedrock, no, and integrity. Mm-hmm. Panawagan natin dun sa mga drug companies na ganyan ang ugali. Ayusin din natin ang inyong pamamalakad.
The Pharmaceutical and Healthcare Association of the Philippines also condemning the alleged practice. PIAP says it is appalled by reports. Some of those in the pharmaceutical industry are not abiding by laws and regulations governing their business practices.